Excuse me. Can you use the back door?
Please?
Can you use the back door, please?
The back door?
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
We have noticed that in a space like this, not everyone is as confident or as comfortable to participate. So we are trying to find the reasons why this is happening. And in order to do that, we would like one volunteer. Okay, so the purpose is to ask some questions that may help us to define where your confidence comes from.
Okay, so should I ask the questions or should you ask me?
Okay, everyone, I invite you to ask this person questions. Of course, you're free to not reply to questions. Yes. So let's ask this one. I would suggest in English because not everyone speaks.
You should only speak English or German.
Well, is there someone that does not speak German?
English is fine for me. But if you have a person in German, I can also translate.
But is there anyone that doesn't speak English?
Yeah.
You? You don't speak English? Can you translate? A little bit. And is there anyone else that doesn't speak English at all?
Two people.
Okay, but they speak German?
Yes.
Yes,
so, perfect.
What made you volunteer? Was hat dich bewogen, mich freiwillig zu
machen? I think because I'm curious. Ich bin neugierig. And I don't like awkward silences so much, so I thought, okay. I didn't know that I would be this much in the center, but it's okay.
And how much percent of confidence do you think that you have?
I don't think I have a lot of confidence. I just tend to ignore that I don't have that much confidence.
So if you had to put a number?
I would say maybe 50%. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Who do you think in this place is more confident than you?
Well, there are some people that I have the feeling that are part of the setup, so I'm not going to point it down. You look quite confident. Yeah, I saw you wave before. You can also at the camera, maybe. So I think you could be confident as well. And you look also very relaxed, so I think you don't feel this uncomfortable.
Yes, that's right.
What do you think how somebody would behave who had double the confidence of you? Like 100%.
Maybe if I was very, very confident, then I would already have turned this into an amazing event and we would have like a big party, but just not. Sure. But
how was your childhood? Because we have to track
where
the.
It's maybe a good starting point. I grew up my first years in a skyscraper, but then I moved with my parents to a little house, very bad house actually, but surrounded by a beautiful garden. And I think I had a very free and rather wild childhood in this garden, more than in the house that was more broken.
Do you have brothers and sisters?
Yeah, I have a sister and a brother.
Older?
Both younger. Yeah, but my brother is much more confident than me, actually. Because he has like this proper job, like not like artist, but he's like becoming a medicine person, so I think that helps the ego. I'm a designer, yeah. And then you always have to question yourself, it can be very annoying.
How was your time at school?
Actually not very nice. Like at first, my elementary school was okay, but when I moved to the upper school, there were some people bullied very much, and first of all, I wasn't bullied that much, but then I wanted to help my friends, and then I also got into this whole fight thing. I didn't like it at all, so I actually changed school. Yeah, so I wasn't confident at all at that point, I would say.
Do you think
you could
be good looking?
Sorry?
Me? With a relation with
feeling
good looking,
feeling
confident.
If I feel I didn't sleep and I look awkward, then I don't feel good to be in public, but maybe because I like this shirt, I also felt confident to still be here. No, I don't know, but it's true, right? I mean, it's these things. Yeah. No, I don't think I'm particularly good looking. But, yeah.
Is your confidence still at the level of 50, or has it risen now? Or
not really. I'm starting to feel very like now you know all these things about me, but I don't know anything about you, so that feels a bit not to be the right balance, actually.
So right now you drop to level of 30.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
I would like to invite you.
I'm in school, like sometimes I feel confidence can be very low, and then if you go through some phase of difficulty and you survive it, that can strengthen your confidence. Do you have a similar experience?
Yes,
kind of.
What is it? time in school was, I don't know, kind of hard. Yeah. Because I wasn't really good in school, and there were people who didn't like me, so I don't know, because I was a bit different. I don't really know.
What do you mean different?
I was interested in other things.
Yes.
Yeah.
Which?
I don't know, like more like not like playing computer games and stuff.
Yes.
More like, I don't know, drawing, dancing.
Yeah. Yes. I understand, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, I understand.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think also like children can be really like, think that you have to be a certain way. Yeah, it's difficult to accept that somebody is different.
I think in this world it's very difficult to be yourself.
Yeah.
You have to be like much more people. Every thought is a talk. Not this, not that. Much people want to be here themselves, and to reach it, that's very, very difficult. feel comfortable in nature, love trees, very nice air, and then such thing as a stereo. When you are yourself, you can live in a group. I think.
Yes, I think that should be the goal, but I don't think that this is what people are actually doing. I think that if you see the masses of people following something, I don't think it's about themselves, I think it's about belonging to something and not standing out of the masses.
Yes.
I think that's a problem, actually.
Yeah, for many people, yes, but not for everyone.
Yes.
You have to
for the world.
You have to find your range of living.
Do you think that confidence has something to do with the economical system that you are familiar with? Like that capitalism promotes more confident people or wants to be more confident in order to be successful?
But there are several other things. In my second World War, that wasn't with capitalism. This war was Hitler or something. Yet, also, why some people are running behind some religion?
So we don't think that capitalism promotes?
No.
Well,
I don't think so.
It has mechanisms for some people to gain confidence, as any system has its mechanisms to gain confidence that are different from system to system, but there are always mechanisms to gain confidence. So it's not particular for capitalism to make people confident. It makes some people confident by giving them power through money, but other systems provide confidence through other means.
There is a
gaming
industry that for them is important, so we have a lot of people feeling comfortable because they buy, and they buy things to feel better. And this is a lot of related to capitalism.
So to connect what you said with what you said that you feel a bit more confident because you wear the shirt.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, but only on a very superficial level, right? I mean, that's also, I think this shirt couldn't help me any longer than 2 minutes to survive. Then we talk about different things. And I also, like, can attach to what you say is, like, of course, like capitalism has this kind of dynamic to force you as an individual to step out and say I'm important and I'm better than other people. I would be curious actually to look at other economic systems, how they deal with that. Maybe, I'm not sure, maybe it didn't matter in a communist system to be confident, but I don't believe that actually. It's also there were discussions and there was some people that were overdrawn and other people with their confidence. So, maybe then confidence wasn't talked about that much, but I think it was definitely also present.
What is your economical situation?
I'm poor. I worked a bit, I got some money, now I study again, I have to save money. But that's, I get a bit of funding from the government, but it's not enough to survive, actually. Yeah.
Do you think your confidence comes from your nationality?
Maybe in some situation it can, but what are your thoughts about it? Because
you asked this, like, no, do you think other nationalities are not as confident?
Yeah, maybe you are confident because of your color, your blonde hair, your green t-shirt, your blue eyes.
yeah, but there are lots of blonde people in this room as well, so I shouldn't feel so special.
But you're not.
I don't know.
You're feeling 50%.
Yeah, but I mean, I have been to other countries and it's true, like, then sometimes I was, for example, in Japan and I felt all of a sudden treated much more respectful than I'm used to when I was in my own country. And I thought, like, why, like, first I thought that's really nice and of course everybody enjoys to be treated that nicely, but it's also a way of discrimination. But I would, like, in my particular case, I wouldn't really point out on that because, you know, I think for some males it's very easy to be just male, and but I always found myself, like, in situations that I had to define my own masculinity. So, no, I'm not that much, actually. I don't give that much about that.
Or every race. Have the same level of confidence, imagining yourself as a bird.
Is it
my
bird?
Bird.
Ah, girl.
my confidence is mainly stuff. Mainly.
Yeah. What is confidence? I mean, what is your definition of confidence? Because I was trying to tell myself, oh, confidence is this, but I don't have definition in my mind. So, if someone I can help me to
define, I think that several types of confidence. Mm-hmm. So I'm very close to creative confidence, but I think that the confidence we were discussing here before is something different, which I don't know so good, and I just couple with the male stuff, basically.
Okay. I didn't got a lot about that, the acoustic. I don't know, yeah, but no, in this case, of, I don't know. Okay, maybe, like, because of this gender stuff, I really have a little bit of difficulty to explain this, but if you don't feel like you represent, like, all these other males that I also sometimes I'm a bit wary of these stigmas, then I'm like, I wouldn't want to step up and say, like, so much that I represent is a male attitude. But yeah, I'm not sure. Who in this room feels really masculine?
So maybe we should also examine someone, examine. We should also make questions to someone else that is maybe more confident, more than 50%. So, who do you think that is more confident? Or if you have a volunteer?
I think she's very confident, but in the end it's also a bit of a decision. You want to be the subject of questions? Yeah.
Why do you think he thought you're the most confident? Why do you think he thought you're confident?
I think he thought I'm relaxed. And I think it's a good, confidence is not a special thing, it's already there. But if you feel close to yourself, then you can use it, feel it.
To be close to yourself?
Yes.
Is that what it is?
not standing in the center. I think it's interesting that the conversation started with you still at the edge of the circle and not coming into the center like he had to do it before. So it like it's a shift in position and in asking and taking. It's quite interesting that he not took the space and said, yeah, ask me.
I don't think it's necessary. I think it's a lot of focus if I stand here or there. But for me, it's interesting. A group needs somebody to focus. It's me. It's okay. But the group process goes better if there's somebody focused. But as I saw him standing here, I saw we all are in there. We all are questioning. We are not answering. We as well are part of the process.
So where are you from?
Wuppertal, Germany.
What's your profession?
I'm a teacher, and I'm a capitalist Unternehmer.
What is that?
Entrepreneur.
Entrepreneur.
Do you think you're better at communication? Hmm? Better at the communication?
What?
You are, compared with him, you are better at communication. Communicate with people, communicate with the environment, communicate with yourself.
I didn't get your question, sorry. Mm.
Do you think?
I'm better in communication?
Yes.
Oh, I don't think that's a good question because it doesn't matter if I'm better or not. It's matter if we understand. Communication is good when me and you feel connected. Then it's good communication. And sometimes it's better, sometimes it's worse.
Does your confidence come from being a teacher?
Or is it
a condition for being a teacher?
No. I think it's my personal way. I loved this profession very much, and I had the chance in this capitalism system to do what I loved. That gives me strength.
And being used to communicate as part of your profession makes you probably confident to step up here and take up the challenge to stand in the middle.
I think I'm a very lucky situation. I love my work. I'm an entrepreneur and I love it very much. I can do what I love and that feels good.
What do you mean with being close to yourself? Give me a picture or something?
Yes. I had the luxus to listen if it feels good what I do. If I have a job, somebody make a speech or make a course or a seminar, and I can feel, oh, I want this, okay, then I do it. And that's.
And if you don't want to, you don't do it.
I don't have to.
Do you have a psychoanalyst?
Yeah.
Okay.
What do you think, because you teach children, or if, okay, how important or what kind of role does that play for your class? Do you ever question yourself? Like, or do you think about the students in the way that you think, oh, he's not that confident or she's not confident? Does that change anything for you?
If I feel that the pupils are not confident.
Are certain people maybe, do you ever consider their level of confidence?
I'm out of school and I have a dream to make the school as a self-growing organism.
Okay.
I think that is to change a lot. And the self-growing
teachers sometimes at work, a lot of school or something, but not in contact with the pupils. And I think that has to grow into
Do you think your confidence comes from you are truly honest to be yourself?
Am I truly what?
I mean, you just be yourself. You don't pretend to be someone else. You just like be yourself. Your confidence comes from.
Yes, it has to. It's not all easy for me, but yes, that's the only person I really know. Me, other people I don't really know.
So being confident is a characteristic that is on our DNA, being born with confidence or with no confidence. It is not in our exterior reality, it's not in our environment. Does confidence builds up because of the exterior reality that we are in, or we are born with confidence, or not?
I think we are born with confidence, and a lot of things disturb it. Socializing, disturb it. And we, as teacher and parents, have to look for the disturbance, to get the disturbance away, or to make it grow, to let it grow again, or to heal again, or something like that.
Do you mean everybody is born with confidence? Is that it?
Yeah. I think.
The same level of.
I think everybody is born with.
Similar, and then the environment.
Yeah, the social life is not similar.
Yeah.
Sure. But the first moment, I think, yes.
But I would just agree if I spend small kids, then I know that are really different in their level of confidence. There's kids that are 2 years old, and they're really confident, and kids in the same age, they have the same parents, they grow up the same way. Mm-hmm. But because also I think everyone is born with a different character. It's not that we are an empty vessel and everything is just built in on the outside. So I think actually that also confidence has something to do, like that people are born with different sense of confidence maybe. You can grow maybe or lose it on the way of growing up, but I think there's definitely you're born with a certain kind of character as well.
Yes, I think so. But for me, it's not the opposite to be confident. Even if you have a very a sickness or a character which is very very
sensible
and take many challenges of not, I think to accept it makes you confident. Even if you have a really worse person. My the father of my husband had a sickness, but he was a inherited sickness, but he was so confident with his age, and he was accepted, and he made a lot of, was a wise man.
Some of them are really confident, some of them not. You like look at them and you like giving them a note and everything. Is it like you, what's it called? You like, you say, yeah, okay, he's a little bit more sensible and he's better in this and this, so I give him more like something of this. And stuff like this, are you like looking around, or you like you have your notes and you give it to them every day, or do you like change stuff for personal
Okay, sorry, can I interrupt?
Mm-hmm.
So, firstly, you are not able to hear? Oh, so let's stay.
The acoustic is hard.
Yeah.
That's part of the performance, part of the thing.
It is part, yeah. So, you want to leave? Bye. So, because we noticed that there are some particular people that make questions all the time, so we wanted to introduce another way that we continue speaking, and for that we have to make a real circle, a proper one, with everybody.
So you don't know what is really confidence, and maybe we can mistake confidence with arrogance sometimes, or I don't know. So maybe like a suggestion to be starting from deciding or defining or describing what is confidence. That is the only thing. But I have no idea.
I was thinking about like being asked how you call. It's really something, it's not that I'm always that thing, it really undulates a lot, so I can be very confident, I'm not at all. And so I've been asking myself, what's confidence like, as you did for me? And I just found your answer, being close to yourself, really like, not being far from yourself, being close, that I love that. Your answer was my answer. And I love your head.
I think confidence comes from situation, your character, and your belongings. I think confidence is really depends. Like you said, like sometimes confidence born in nature, the one with confidence, and sometimes just the situation changes you. So I think it really depends.
I noticed that in my interpretation, both people that spoke about their confidence were kind of successful. You have a good studies, you have a good business. I would like to hear a waiter or a waitress to speak about their confidence in this space. Go in the center of the room and say, yes, I'm a waitress and I have confidence. So I would like someone that does something more common to speak about their confidence.
Oh, sorry. I work in a cafe, but I don't know. I don't define myself as a waitress, so it's not so bad. I know that I'm not going to be doing it my whole life, and right now it's quite fun. It's a nice job. And it's a nice cafe, so I suppose I'm not the typical waitress. The person who is just waiting for things to happen. I'm going to start to study this winter semester. But I feel like confidence is something that you have to learn, and you have to challenge yourself to build it. I don't know, sometimes you have to say, okay, I'm going to go into the middle of the circle and speak. And afterwards you'll say, okay, it wasn't that bad. I'll do it again next time, and it won't be so hard. Yeah, so I feel like confidence some people have more of it and some people have less of it when they're younger, and then you just have to get through. Yeah.
And I think you can draw the confidence of a lot of different things beside the job. So maybe your family or some hobby or so. This makes you also confident. But relating to one of the questions you put before on capitalist, I mean, what I find interesting is that capitalism is putting so much pressure on the individual. So there's not much space, if you think in terms of what we have to achieve as an individual, there's not much space for confidence. I mean, we are responsible, we are held responsible for our education, for our life, for our pension. Everything is put on us as an individual and not on something else. So I always wonder why people are still confident in this situation, why they manage to be happy with themselves. So it's,
yeah. Because, I don't know, maybe if you...
I don't want to speak.
Why not?
Because I don't feel confident. I don't like speaking in spaces.
I am very amazed about what you said, because I think what you said about the we are speaking about success, like him, that he's a designer. Let's speak about the waiter. What do you mean? This is what I understood. No? I think that's a reduction of success and of life. Why his success of I had by being a designer, and she's not, or somebody is not success by being a waiter. I mean, I didn't understand. I think you make a clear. You were speaking of, you present a cliché or a way of thinking, very weird for me. And also yourself, you are connecting success with being sure of yourself, no? I don't know, and you can be sure of yourself being a waiter or being a designer, and who makes the hierarchy or the categories here, no? I don't know. I didn't understand very well why you said that. Maybe in the next circle you should explain.
I think confidence is very much a matter of context and situation. I myself would not consider myself in general as a very confident person, but depending on context, I can become quite confident. In a situation where I know nobody can harm me, my actions do not have consequences beyond the immediate situation, like here, because I don't know anybody of you except my wife. I can basically make a complete joke of myself and it doesn't matter. That contributes to my confidence in this situation.
I don't want to speak now. I'm still thinking on what is confidence. So I don't have an answer yet, but I hope I will have it at the end of this performance. But I think I'm quite confident. Yeah, confident, usually.
My English is not good. she translates, I say a little bit. Also Selbstbewusstsein hat sehr viel zu tun mit dem Kennen seiner eigenen Stärken und Schwächen, seiner persönlichen Stärken und Schwächen.
Yes, so confidence comes with knowledge of your own. Yeah, confidence comes with knowledge of your own personality and strengths. So.
Und dass man auch seine Grenzen auch kennt und offen ist für Neues und lernt und dann entsteht aus meiner Sicht auch sozusagen selbst.
Also, was heißt Grenzen?
Limits.
Oh, yeah. And it also depends on knowing your own limits. And learning.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. I don't know the answer to. A few weeks ago I was in a lecture in psychology and they talked about that maybe confidence is also a matter of generation. So that younger people are more confident because they are raised to be more confident. So like they told us like they feel like little unicorns, they develop and feel great and are raised to be more confident than ältere Generation. Yeah, the generations before. But I don't know if it's true.
Ja, ich spreche leider kein Englisch.
She doesn't want to speak.
Ich glaube aber, dass jeder einen Bereich hat, in dem er selbstbewusst sein kann und man da auch lernen kann und sich da entwickelt und nicht überall perfekt sein muss.
Yeah, you don't have to be perfect in everything. So you have your heart. Some abilities that makes you confident and others not, but that's okay.
I'm also still thinking about it. I also thought that what you said was really close to what I think is confidence. I think confidence is a feeling, and it's interesting because you feel confident mostly or unconfident around others. So it's also kind of based on the judgment of other people or how they judge you and how you feel towards the other people. So I don't know. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking about right now.
I find it really interesting about all the expressions I got, I don't really know because I don't feel like really a confident person, but I don't really know who tells me that I have to be a confident person because I'm not a confident person, so I don't see the sense to try to be one. But yes, I think like you said that like of course you can build up something if you want to, but I don't really know, if I want to. Because sometimes I feel like confident being just with my own.
So I started thinking that confidence is a mechanism, perhaps, that I can, if I want, activate with my thoughts, and if I don't need to becoming confident, then I can not develop that skill, but it could be something kind of mechanical or like psycho and physiological, but it's a mechanism perhaps that I can train or not.
I agree that it's a feeling, and I believe that we have a lot of ideals of perfection and you need to disconnect from them because otherwise you always be not confident and feeling uncomfortable in being yourself.
I find very interesting what you said. I feel like I'm not confident and that's okay for me because I don't know why would I. I think that's the most confident thing you could express. I don't know. It's because I don't think that confidence is only a thing about in a group or something. Because I think it mostly is the feeling to yourself. And the longer we talk, the more I think it's one of the most important things at all. Just to feel able to do anything because you trust in yourself. In a way, I find it very interesting. I think it's not only it has to do with both, with the others and with yourself. and maybe even more with yourself, because I think we can manipulate ourselves even stronger and more than the others can, when in our thoughts, in our head. That's what I think.
Okay, my heart is pounding. I like that one too. Thought that's a good saying. But still, I think confidence only works in groups, or only in cases of you seeing yourself in groups, even if you're alone. I think you'll always try to imagine yourself in groups. If you see yourself in a mirror, you'll consider yourself walking in the streets, walking through a group, walking with friends. And in that particular moment, you consider yourself in the group, you'll decide if you'll be confident, if the group accepts you as you look, as you feel, the moment you look at yourself, or if it doesn't. Confidence isn't even a thing if you'd be all alone without knowing anyone else, but that's pretty hard to imagine, so I'm not sure.
I think confidence is a question of a question about words, and it's about finding the right words for your own. And also, if you are told the right words by other people, because sometimes somebody else says a word about you, and it destroys your confidence for a whole week. And yeah, but then you have to find the right words for your own to come over it.
Through this circle, I have the question now for me, if it's necessary or even necessary to be confident. So, and it's actually a struggle that I feel, because I'm a person that wants to push myself to be confident from time to time, and sometimes I'm also okay with just stepping back. But then I really envy this freedom that you describe of not having to be confident, and at the same time, sometimes I'm in a situation and I don't speak up, and then I'm really feel bad afterwards, because I think, okay, I could have said something, because I even feel something, and then I'm ashamed of not being confident. That's maybe the struggle. Thanks.
I was asking myself if you can be still confident and actually cry or show yourself vulnerable, and just like let show you the worst of you, and if confidence could come from simply believing in something that lets you ignore some other people's thoughts, or and just keep doing, and if it's right to ignore, or just if it's more interesting rather to come and ask and see if you're wrong, or just keep believing and then it's simply ignoring. So no.
For me, confidence is to trust yourself and to trust others, which is not that easy.
I think confidence is something what you learn through your life. It's an experience you make. It's something you may learn from your parents or not, and what the surrounding is giving you. And some people, or sometimes if people are too confident, it might even lead to arrogance, which, is then maybe a little bit too much, I don't know.
I would like that everybody in Germany, in Europe, in America, in Asia, is confident. And I know that it's an illusion. Even the refugees are confident. I know that's a good, the great illusion, that it's not like it happened now. But I think to be confident is a great resource to get answers to the difficult problems. So I want everybody to be confident.
So I have not decided yet either what confidence is, but I can say for myself that it's certainly something that can be perceived by other people or has to do with other people in situations that occur to me. And I think it has a lot to do with strength and fear. It has to do with how strong you feel to support yourself and your opinions, especially in situations where you don't like. And this is very important, I think. For example, if someone here does not like what is happening and they don't have the confidence to say so, I think this is an issue. It doesn't always have to do with how you seem, or it has a lot of practical impacts on our everyday life, I think.
I was thinking, actually, when did we start caring about, not us, the humanity in general, about being confident or unconfident? And actually, it reminds me of some things that we say, and I think, yeah, you said that you have also heard, or you think that younger people are more confident because we are raised to be so. And I think that we are raised to care about confidence, like we are raised also to believe in ourselves, or to be to try to be ourselves, or to I don't know, to be confident. And I think that this has much to do with the individual, and this has also much to do with our need to dominate others, you know, to be also a little bit stronger, to continue, you know, climbing the ladder of prosperity or I don't know what, and to be also a little bit more antagonistic in our jobs. So to me, this whole confidence notion is very much connected on how we work in capitalism. For example, you need confidence, like to me, the place that you need the most confidence is when you go for a job interview. I think it's like, one of the situations that it's most needed for people to be confident, to sell themselves in a way, to be able to sell themselves. So, of course it's not bad, and everybody needs to feel good with himself or herself, but where I'm thinking about where it comes from as a notion, from when do we care about it. And yes, and of course there is also an interesting issue to see where it comes from to each one of us, why each one of us that feels confident feels. And I think we, in the first part we try to understand a little bit about it.
Can I say something? Okay, it was good that you had to wait that long, because I got a little upset when you mentioned the way you were asking for what's confidence. I would like to ask some average people. Don't you think we're all average people?
Yes.
I think there's a lot here, and at the same time we are all, we did art school, I don't know, some of us, we all have been waiters. And I don't know, I got so upset. I had really to come down.
You don't agree with the fact that the material that surrounds you creates your confidence?
No. I so much agree. I ask myself, oh, me as whatever, artisan, I call myself craftsman. If I was surrounded by a waiter, would I feel that confident or not? So it depends really on my community, who's around me. But it's as if you were looking for something, asking the wrong people somehow. And really that got me so upset. So forgive me, I had to express this.
And also I have a question. I think under the capitalism, people are easily to get confidence. Because here in the Western world, because I'm Chinese, I think people are easily to, they have to speak out. They are trained as a child, they have to stand out and speak out and tell about their ideas. But you know, in the communism, like in Asia, we are trained to be silent, you know. Also silence in Asian culture is a way to protect ourselves, you know. So I think like, yeah.
And you're trained not to speak your mind.
Yeah, you have to, because sometimes it's quite dangerous if you quite talkative.